Back last year, Robin Thicke, T.I. and Pharrell Williams released the R&B smash hit slash date rape advocacy song Blurred Lines. Apart from totally destroying Jermaine Greer's ears, hit me up when you pass through, I give you something big enough to tell your ass to. Letting us know Robin is pretty psyched about his heat-seeking moisture missile. And using boobs to sell an album, the most unexpected part of the Blurred Lines saga is the plagiarism claims. Marvin Gaye's family are currently suing both Thicke and Williams, claiming that Blurred Lines is a rip-off of the 1977 soul hit, You Gotta Give It Up.
Now, opinion time. Is that one in any way similar to the first one?
Yes, in that it is exactly the same.
Yeah, it's very similar.
And US District Judge John Cronstant agrees, choosing to ignore both Thicke and Williams' filing for a summary judgment allowing the suit to go through. Of course, Thicke, for his part, has decided to plead ignorance, saying, I was high on Vicodin and alcohol when I showed up in the studio.
And I have no idea why that sounded like Forrest Gump. Anyways, the trial's gonna happen about February next year, and if the Gaye family wins, it'll have a huge number of impacts on the way the music industry operates.
The judge could set a precedent that even musical phrases of two or three notes could be protected by copyright law. The amount of damages that the quote-unquote creators of Blurred Lines would have to pay could break records and change the music industry forever. And that's terrifying, because stealing is an age-old tradition in the music world.
Whilst Avril Lavigne's song Girlfriend is a terrible song that encourages adultery in Canada, that you also didn't realise that it was stolen.
Now, Lavigne has said she'd never heard of the Rubinoose song I Wanna Be Your Boyfriend before, and she also went so far as to say, quote, all songs share similar lyrics and emotions.
Yeah, except no. See, the Skyhook song Smart is all about masturbating into a Twisties packet at the cinema. A munchy, munchy Twisties, they shots and said you react, make a little opening in the other in the outback. And no, not all songs are about masturbating into a Twisties packet.
And Lavigne did end up paying the Rubinoos an undisclosed amount of money shortly after. It's even happened in our very own proud Team Australia. Yes, Down Under, the most Aussie song since Waltzing Matilda, also stole a couple of bars from the very popular Australian nursery rhyme Kookaburra. Kookaburra sits in the old gum tree,
Mary, Mary, King of the bush is he. You guys suck. That's right. I'm like the Dicker of SBS, destroying dreams and alienating children. And yet, I'm still eating these.
The owners of Kookaburra, yes, apparently you can own a nursery rhyme, sued EMI and Men at Work a total of 28 years after its release, earning 5% of all royalties from the year 2002 onwards. Lead singer and writer Colin Hayes from Men at Work said, what was won today is opportunistic greed, and what has suffered is creative musical endeavour. And then seconds later, he did also kind of admit that they inadvertently referenced a few bars from the song. Getting sued, though, for stealing is like a rite of passage in the music industry. It's happened to everyone. Rod Stewart, The Beatles, Johnny Cash, Radiohead, Oasis, Coldplay, even Ray Parker Jr.'s Oscar-nominated Ghostbusters theme. Something strange in a neighbourhood. Who you gonna call? Ghostbusters! All in all, musicians can argue that they're paying homage, but in the end, what they're really paying will be an out-of-court settlement.